array is a group of similar variables, similar data types. Okay, so I can say int temperature then. Let's say here my assumption is there are 10 different temperature sensors. So I'm creating an array of 10 integers, and in each index I will store the temperature. The count here starts from 0. So the first element is temperature 0. It is written like temperature 0. And the last one is temperature
9. Array index.
Yeah, this is the array index. This is the total size of that array. And in memory, all after the other. That is important because when we use pointers, I will just pass the address of this one element. I will increment the pointer once, I will get this element. I will increment it once again, I will get the next element. Sorry, not this one, I will get temperature 1. Then temperature 2, temperature 3, like that it keeps going. But you see here, all of them must be integer. Let's say I have 10 different rooms. In each room, I have a temperature sensor and I have humidity sensor. So temperature 0 means temperature of room number 0. Humidity 0 means humidity of room number 0. But here the problem is our values are clubbed based on the type of value, not based on the room. So if you want to know for a room, you need to know that index, and each sensor, each array you have to read individually, right? So instead of that, we can use something called structures. So in structures, what we'll do, we'll create, write this struct, the name of the structure, we'll call it rooms, then we'll start our bracket. Here we define the members. Okay, what are the members in the room? We have temperature sensor, humidity sensor. I will write in temperature. In humidity. This is the structure name. These are the members of the structure. And I can end it here. And somewhere else where I want to use, maybe in my main function, I can write struct rooms R1, R2, R10. Okay, I am mentioning 10 room variables. So these are variables of type room. So this is a new data type we have created. This is a user-defined data type. This data type has the members 2 integers. Now instead of 2 integers, I can have any combination, any number of integers, characters, float, anything. So now, to write, I'll write R1.temperature. R1.humidity. So similarly for R2, R3, R4, R10. Now you see what is happening is, this variable R1, this is storing the humidity and temperature information for room 1. You don't have to read temperature and humidity separately. You want the temperature of room 1, R1.temperature. You don't have that array now. Now these are the variables. Okay, instead of writing 10 different variables, you can write R10 here. So here also you are creating the array. The number of variables, total memory locations are going to be same. But now your information is grouped in a room. There it was separate. Okay. Now you want to run it through a loop. Let's say you want to take the average of the temperature of all the rooms. You put it in a for loop. Here it will be R i.temperature. Okay, that way you can do similarly for humidity, that is structure. And in this also, the memory locations will be, first will be temperature, next will be humidity. So you have temperature, you have humidity. This is R1. Just after R1, you will have R2. This is temperature, humidity. This is temperature, this is humidity. And for structures also you can take the pointers. So if you take a pointer for this R1 suppose, if you take or say R0, if you take the address of this, if you use it as a pointer, right now you are using a dot operator. This is a dot operator. If directly the structure variable, if you are using the structure variable directly and want to access the members, you will use dot operator. If you are doing it through pointers, you will use the arrow operator. You will do R0 temperature.
Double pointer means double arrow. Double dot, double arrow.
No, no, no.
Say something.
No, you won't be double dot. I have not seen it anywhere and it will lead to confusion. So what you do is you dereference it once and then use the dereference well. Okay, let's say you are passing the
structure within the structure. You are calling that structure variable outside the structure, double dots.
Structure within the structure means here you have another, let's say struct. What name should we give?
Okay, inside the room some
ABC available. So what I am saying is struct ABC is a member of struct rooms. And ABC has variables say in A, in B. Now if I want to access A, I have to give R0 for room 0 dot ABC dot A. Because A is not a member of rooms. I cannot access it directly. I have to access it through this structure. This one you cannot write ABC, ABC is the name, so I will write struct ABC X. So X is the name of that structure variable and here I will write X.
Double dot and all my non-purpose.
Now if I pass the address of R0, let's say I store it in some variable PTR. So to read the temperature, I will write PTR arrow temperature. So PTR is storing the address of R0. R0 is a structure variable and it has temperature. So it will give you the temperature of room 0. Now if I increment PTR once, PTR also should be of type struct rooms. So I have to declare PTR, I have to write struct rooms star PTR. Then only it will store the address of that structure. Now if I increment PTR, it will reference to R1. Increment it again, it will reference to R2. That way it will keep going.
Type depth struct means
type depth struct, if you are writing, you don't have to write struct rooms and this thing. You directly write rooms. So now this is structure. Similarly we have unions. The main difference between structure and union is how it is stored in memory. In structures all the member variables have separate memory one after the other. In unions all of them will have the same memory location and that memory location will be of size of the greatest member variable. Let's say you have int temperature, int humidity and you have some char ch. So this is union. So you will have one memory location of 4 bytes. That is only temperature, that is only humidity, and one byte of this will be CH. Okay. Or if I have an array CH4, then this 4 CH array indexes, they will share this whole memory location. This will be CH0, CH1, CH2, CH3. Okay. If it was structure, they would have individual locations. Temperature, humidity, CH0, CH1, CH2, CH3. Here they are sharing the same memory location.
IS1
is integer, so
4 bytes.
Yeah, and when you check the size of this using the size of operator, it will show you 4 bytes. If instead of union you make it structures, it will show you 4 plus 4, 8 plus 4, 12. Now, how unions can be useful? During packing and unpacking. Okay, let's say instead of CH, we will take one variable here in status. Now status is 4 bytes. So one way when you want to transmit the data, it will transmit 8 bits at a time, 1 byte. So you have to do 4 transmissions. And to transmit it, you have to do status. You have status. You first transmit the lowest byte. Then you right shift it 8 times. And then you transmit the lowest byte. Then you transmit it, right shift it 16 times, then you transmit it, then you right shift it 0, 8, then 16. Yeah, that will do. First you just transmit it, then right shift 8, transmit, right shift 16, transmit. Instead of that, what you do here is, whatever value is there in status, you have the whole memory location. You have the 4 bytes of the status. This one is CH0, CH1, CH2, CH3. Okay. So whatever value stored in status is automatically segregated in 4 different bytes. Now you transmit this 4. Other side where you are receiving it, you receive them in this 4. Part of union only. You are receiving in this 4 and directly read this variable, you have the whole information. So how you can test it in C? You create 2 unions. First union, you give some value to status. Then in the function, you copy CH these values to the other characters. And then you read the other union's status. You should get the same value. Okay? So this is one very good way when you want to transmit or separate it in multiple bytes without doing all the left shift, right shift and all. Okay. So anything else in C?
Enum.
Enum is simple, like you give a enum, you give a name, and the first one you have given some name, it will take the value 0 by default. The next one will take value 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. So when you create an enum variable, dot that name, it will return the value. If you start with some other value, let's say 3, the next one will be 4, 5, 6. Or you can individually assign them values. So similar to structures, you just use the dot operator. Instead of that name, it will return your value.